Welcome to Skull's Federal DPS Guide. This will be a basic introduction split up into several videos. I will start with the DPS abilities. Feather Fire reduces the enemy's armor. Mango increases our bleed damage and generate combo points. Rake, a bleed that generates combo points. Rip, a bleed that we use as a finisher. Tiger's Fury, a DPS cooldown which we use each 30 seconds. Berserk is our 3-minute cooldown that decreases energy cost of every ability. Savage Roar is a finisher that increases our auto-attack damage. Shred is our main combo point generator that requires us to be behind the target. Ferocious Bite is a finisher which we use with care. And let's not forget about Swipe, which is the Feral's AoE. And Ravage, which is a bonus attack we can use while stealthed or after Feral charging or with the 4 set of tier 13. Then we have some survival abilities. Bark Skin, which reduces the damage taken by 20%. Survival Instinct, which reduces the damage taken by 50%. And when it comes to utility, Ferals have quite some things that can be useful. One of them are Feral Charge, which makes you charge to the enemy's ass so you can attack them from behind. Frenzied Regeneration, that provides more health and healing taken if glyphed, and if you have tier 13 4 sets, you will give this to the whole raid.
Skill Bash, which is our interrupt. Maim, a stun that consumes combo points. Bash, a stun which requires spear farm. Cover, a threat dump.
Dash, a speed increase that makes you move 70% faster. Stampeding Roar, a speed increase that makes you and your buddies around you move 60% faster. Tranquility, a group heal, which is quite strong and should be used to aid the healers. Innovate, a mana restoring cooldown which you can use if you feel like being a superhero. I mean, I'm sure the casters will be grateful for the 5k mana that you can give them. Moving on to rotation. The Feral rotation is basically a list of priorities. Number 1, keep Fairy Fire up. Number 2, keep Mangle up. Number 3, keep Rake up. Number 4, use Tiger's Fury on cooldown, but not with more than 35 energy. Number 5, use Berserk on cooldown, unless you're saving it for a specific moment in the fight, and you only use Berserk with full energy. Number 6, keep Rip up. Number 7, keep Savage Roar up. Number 8, Ferocious Bite if you feel that you can fit it in, but this is a judgment call and you should skip it if you do not feel comfortable and are like new to the spec. The opener is the hard part, so I'm going to show you a sample of how it's done. You start by Feral charging in, mid-air you do a Fairy Fire, then you Mangle, Rake, Ravage, Shred, Tiger's Fury, Berserk, Rip, Rake, Ravage and spam Shred until your Tiger's Fury buff is out. After this, you do a Savage Roar, then you keep spamming Shred for the remainder of your Berserk. When they reach 10 energy, you can use Ferocious Bite, but a note here is that you don't use Ferocious Bite during Berserk unless you're going to end it up with 30-50 energy, and then you use it to burn the excess energy that you have. So let's have a look at the talents. I'm not going to go through every single talent and what it does, but rather focus on the ones that are important to know for a good overview. 0347 is the spec that I would go for as a Feral Cat. For progression, I'd recommend 0329 for extra mitigation. Feral Swiftness increases our movement speed by 30%. Feral Aggression increases our damage of Ferocious Bite by 10% and makes Feral Fire apply 3 stacks. Stampede gives us a free Ravage after we use Feral Charge. King of the Jungle makes our Tiger's Fury restore 60 energy. Random Tear gives Ferocious Bite 25% more crits if the target is bleeding. Blood in the Water causes Ferocious Bite to refresh Rip sub 25%. This is basically our execute. Glyphs are pretty straightforward. The three prime glyphs which we use are Berserk, that increases the duration of Berserk. Rip, which increases the damage of the dot. Bloodletting, which increases the duration of Rip. For major glyphs, we use Rebirth, that makes people we rest come back with full health. Ferocious Bite, which makes us heal when we use the ability. The third one doesn't really matter what you use. I personally use Frenzied Regen for the raid, but if you want to be a super cat, you know, you can just use Fatal Charge or Fairy Fire Glyph. As a minor glyph, you can use whatever you want, as long as you have Dash Glyph and Unburdened Rebirth Glyph. So to end this up, I'm going to mention some useful links for Fatals. The first link is a link to Mihir's cat guide on my MMO champion. It's a really good guide which goes through Feral DPS more in depth. The second one is a link to fluiddruid.com, which is a community site for Feral DPS and some other off-topic stuff as well. A very good site to discuss with your fellow druid mates. And the third link is a link to the cat simulator called Mew, which you use to theorycraft and determine upgrades, etc. And that is all for this video. If you have any questions at all, then feel free to PM me on methodvava.com. On the next video, we will go over UI and macros. And remember to subscribe!